What is up, guys? I'm Kelly. I'ma bleep my name. If you're new to this channel, welcome. I don't know what I'm doing with this channel. I'm just creating videos to help people and help myself become more creative and possibly help you guys do or inspire you guys to do whatever you want to. So if you have been sticking to my channel, we're gonna go into a different video today. I had one video called three things to expect after, or three things to consider after graduating college and moving back in or something like that. I'll put the link up here or something. But we're gonna go into life after college. That's one thing that I haven't really seen a lot of videos of. And I wanted to get into the nitty gritty and my struggles as well as tips that can help you if your life is after college and you don't know what to do. First things first, I wanna give you my background and then let you know where I am and how I'm doing, and then I'll get into the tactics and all the stuff that can help you guys find a job or anything like that. So we're gonna get into that. So about me, I went to Iowa State University from 2013 to 2017. That is 4 years, and it is now 2018, and it's been a year later after college. But life was not sweet for me after graduating. I graduated in summer officially. I walked in May, but I graduated officially in summer, all because I didn't have an internship during my college years. My junior, senior year, I didn't really know what I really wanted to do specifically in the major that I studied, which is graphic design. And it was a little more, it was more hard to get a job because when you are in the creative field, you're based mostly off of your work. And the work that I've done while I was in college was not that good, to be honest. Looking back at it, it was not that good. But luckily, I landed an internship during June or so last year, and that lasted up until like August, almost September. So I ended that internship, and then I didn't have a job. I was searching for a job, but in the meantime, I took community college classes to help better my skills and everything. One reason that I really wasn't getting a job was because I was working on a website. I didn't have a website, an official website designed or made by me, so I can showcase my work. And I was basically going, showing people PDFs and things like that, rather than showing my website and the work that I did via website. So luckily I took coding classes, at least one semester of coding classes in Iowa State, and that was my senior year. So then I just started using the skills that I learned then, and then made my website. I designed it myself and everything like that. I'll probably like leave a link or you'll see a video of it. After that, I started just applying with what I had. I used the Adobe portfolio websites in the meantime while I was coding my website, so I can at least have people look at what I was doing. It took me a good long time. I left videos on there too, on my YouTube, so if you check it out, I was like, it was in November around this time when I was like starting to get interviews after I've been applying for months since my internship ended, or like the last week of my internship, I started applying for jobs. And no answers at all, nothing was happening. So I made a video about all these, my whole journey about this basically. And in November-ish, I had some few interviews, but they didn't really go anywhere. I was kind of like just wasting time applying for jobs. And then my friend JP at Kahindo Tech, I'll also leave a card up there. He told me about how to apply without wasting time. And I used those principles, but I'll get into that later. So that happened around November. So I made a video on YouTube. I was trying to get creative and just not stay stagnant, because that was one thing that I know that would get me down and keep me depressed if I was staying stagnant. And I like to create, so I created videos for YouTube. There's one video I made specifically called How to Vlog, or I forgot what it was. Or yeah, How to Vlog, or something similar, with the camera that I had at the time, which was the Canon T5. And I made that video, put it up. Nothing really happened with it, to be honest. 10 views here. And at this time, I had like 7 subscribers. Then all of a sudden, later down the road, I now have almost 3,000 views on this, like 2,500 or something like that. But yeah, so I created that video at that time and I just let it happen. And then I just kept vlogging and vlogging and just documenting my journey. I took video classes in college, or in the community college I was telling y'all about. And I ended up making a video, which ended up helping me start Calicacies. With all that being said, I was making sure I was being very creative and just using my brain and my talents and everything that I could to help just build my portfolio and just get out of my ordinary state, which was kind of sad at that point. It's not going out much. I wasn't really talking to people. I was very kind of shy. Like, I still kind of am shy, but I was just not talking to anybody and everything like that. So then around when school, community college classes were ending around December-ish, I got a call from a good company. They're actually number one in what they were doing at the time, which is like some furniture company, but they needed to design a catalog. And I accepted the position, although it's for low money. I was just looking for anything at this point, so I accepted the position. It was freelance, basically, so I had a W-9, independent contract work and all that stuff like that, and I did that. I did that for at least 3 months, but for a month solid, I was working there in the office and doing all this work for them. After that, during around February-ish, I just started applying for more jobs, and I got one at the startup. It was downtown Dallas. It was cool. It was gorgeous. The work was pretty cool. It was creative, but it felt really off. I don't know what it was, yada yada. I kept working, and then all of a sudden, I got fired on my way home from the train, and I couldn't do anything about it. I had no time to cry. I had nothing like that. I couldn't feel anything, so I just went home, created some more stuff, which was the new intro that I made for the video that I made during March 1st or something like that. So I did that, I made a video about it, I created the intro for it. I just used my talents because I didn't want to waste emotion on something that happens to people, and I just couldn't feel anything. I didn't have time to. I was like, yo, let me just boom, 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 let me get stuff started. Let me just keep applying for jobs, and it happened for a month straight. And then I got a call saying an interview. I went to the interview like a week or something later. Then I picked up the phone. I was like, hello, this, they want to meet you. And then I met them. And then they called me. They said they really liked me. They liked my personality and all that stuff like that, which I will also get into later. And then I ended up getting the job. It was a temp position at the time, but then recently, in last week or this week technically, I got a full-time position with them, so I'm kind of happy with that. So I have a job. But regardless, and between all those times I was making YouTube videos, whatever came to my mind, so I just stayed creative. So that's all about me. So now we're gonna get into the tactical parts and what I did to help land me a job. Also, not be so down in the dumps always as well. And also, I'm gonna try to help you the best I can with the information I'm gonna give you. So first things first for me, one thing that I knew that would help me is if I stay in a positive mindset and also be active. I personally believe that you will be very sad. Post-grad depression will hit you hardest if you're not active. It will hit you hardest if you're not active because now you're constantly sitting down doing nothing with your body, being active and letting your body's blood rush into different places of your brain to help function. Don't sit down and be down in the dumps if you're not having a job or nobody's calling you yet. Just keep grinding and grinding. You don't have to grind as hard as you do every day if you don't want to, but make sure you're always taking at least a step a day. At least a step a day. You don't have to take 5 steps, but some days five steps, some days 1 step. As long as you're taking 1 step, as that means applying or being active or doing something that doesn't involve just sitting down and sulking in the post-grad depression that you have. Another thing that helped me, and I said this in my Notes to Self video, I put it for myself, but you can watch it up here too. Building a relationship with God. I'm a Christian, just to preface that. I'm a Christian, and I wasn't the best Christian. So I made a vow to myself to just be more spiritual and just get back on track with my relationship with God, Jesus, and everything too. So that was a big factor because I used to pray every time. And even the days I didn't want to pray, I made sure I prayed. I forced myself to pray so I can get at least in that habit and built that habit. And I still have that habit today for the most part. It's a slow process from my view. It's a slower process than what I'm viewing. So I would also suggest that being spiritual, getting back to church, listening to just podcasts about Christianity if you're a Christian. I would suggest Christianity. That's why I'm putting so much emphasis on Christianity. If you're not a Christian, I definitely would suggest you being it. but also at the same time, just do reading on like spiritual and mental things. Do a bunch of exercises as well, so you're not just reading and not doing anything. The third thing, which is a very crucial thing, and it also ties in with the first thing of being active. Be creative. If you're in a creative field like me, you have to work on your portfolio. If you haven't taken any web design classes to help boost your skills in other areas that involve design, like web design or anything like that, then I would definitely get on that. YouTube is free. You can go to, if you have a laptop or a phone or whatever, use your resources that you have and learn how to do other things other than just your field. So for me, I built my social IQ up, my EQ up, all those things during that. My IQ up, my knowledge of other things as well too. You have to, like, that's what's gonna separate you from most people applying. And if you don't do that, you're gonna die in the crowd of normal. So I think that those things will definitely like help you, especially being creative and learning in a different field other than yours. Apply those skills that you have into the skill or the job that you want to go into, so you have a broader view and perspective of different things. That really helped me, because having a high social IQ for me, learning how to code, learning how to design code, trying to build an app, all these things like that helped me become a better candidate. And luckily I was blessed enough to be hired and just accepted in that position that I am now. So those are three major things for sure. And make sure, please, do not be stagnant. I would definitely suggest listening to Gary Vaynerchuk, the Jordan Harbinger Show. I'll link those in the description below so you can listen to them. And I would, if you're a Christian or wanting to become a Christian or curious about it, the Bible Project is definitely one thing that you should definitely check out. It's very cool animations and things like that. It will help you understand Christianity and faith and building your faith and things like that. Another thing that I would suggest is watching physical activity videos such as the Buff Dudes or Athlenex to help you get into it'll help get you into the physical activity part, so you're not letting yourself sulk in depression, I guess you would call it. Those things very much help me, and it'll definitely spark something new into your brain. I promise you that. It'll give you a new perspective, and these people are harsh. These people don't care about your feelings as much. Well, they care about your feelings, but they give you the truth, and the truth will hurt. It took me a long time to understand that too, and a lot of things I'm still understanding, but the truth will hurt, and it'll help you tremendously. I would definitely suggest those things. Hopefully everything I said today you will take into account and just help you apply for jobs. Which is another thing, is the job part. Where do you apply? Where do you put all your resumes and stuff like that? Indeed.com is the number one! Is the number one reason why I'm getting these interviews. I'm sorry, ZipRecruiter was not that good for me anyway, but I was also in the creative field. But Indeed.com, especially if you're in the creative field, will definitely help. And I can't stress that enough, fam. I cannot stress that enough. Another thing is ZipRecruiter. They help you too. But creatives, I would definitely suggest more so Indeed. But put all your eggs in those baskets. Robert Half is another one. It's attempt to hire agency. Robert Half. Robert Half, Monster.com, all these companies I will link below in the description so you can find whatever you need and whatever city that you need to. These things will definitely help you guys. I hope some, at least one or two people can do all the things that at least follow some of the steps that I said in this video. Hopefully they can follow the steps in this video and they will get something. And if you do get something, please let me know. I definitely want to build a community in this channel. I don't want to be just one of those guys who just talks and not interacts with their fans. I see that a lot. Or I'm not even gonna say fans, to be honest, because it's not a fan, it's really a family. And most of my friends that are watching this video are friends, and they're not like fans or anything like that. Thank y'all. If y'all have any more questions, just hit me up. I have my Twitter here, I have my Instagram here, Follow me on Snapchat, because Snapchat is not dead, I'm telling you. I have a bunch of stuff that you can just reach me out onto. Put even in the comment section below. Let me know in the comment section below if I helped you at all, if it does help, or any way that I can help you. So thank you all for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. If you don't like the video, dislike and leave a comment and tell me why. If you like the video, like and tell me why you liked it if you want to. Or if you want to have a discussion with each other, leave it all in the comment section below. Thank y'all for watching. Thank you guys for supporting me, to my friends, family, all of that. Crack, crack, kick, kick, kick. Thank y'all for watching. I hope this helps some of y'all. I really don't know what else to say, but thank y'all so much. I'll see y'all in my next video. Peace.